Makeup Forever, we know them. We love them. Literally one of my favorite brands for bases throughout the last decade. They've also been giving and serving cream palettes for a long time. Staples in the makeup community for a lot of artists and just daily users. But I think they said, let me upgrade y'all in 2022. Greetings and salutations. Hey girl, hey, what is up? Today we have the brand new online exclusive HD Skin All-in-One Face Palette from Makeup Forever. This comes in two different shades. This is Harmony 1, so two different sets, I should say, which looks like this. And there's also Harmony 2, which I will put on the screen right now. These retail for $85. And within the palette, you get four concealers, three foundations, two contours, two blushes, and one highlight. Deal. Great for travel, great for makeup artists. There's also a foundation only version that retails for $110, where you'll get 12 different shades of foundations and they have different sets of it. These are both online exclusives to makeupforever.com, but I mean, it's a value. When I was a freelance makeup artist in the past, I don't do it anymore, and I did weddings, I had a very tall Bobbi Brown cream foundation palette, which allowed me to mix whatever shade I needed. This formulation within this palette and the foundation only version is the HD Skin Cream Foundation Stick, which we have reviewed in a wear test on my channel. One of my favorite formulations within their line. I also really love their Reboot Foundation and their HD Ultra, the OG, not the new tan one. The new tan one doesn't play well with me, but the Cream Stick Foundation, I sang my praises when I first reviewed it. So I won't be wear testing today, but I will be giving you guys a first impression of using this entire palette only for my base and seeing where that takes us. I'm quite excited. I think that'll be a lot of fun, but I think if you are looking for a way to downsize room in your makeup kits or have something easy to travel with, come on. Come on, the concept is there. Let's see if the execution is. And just in case you are hoping for a wear test and you're interested in a wear test on my channel, let me give you a sneak peek of my next two. One being from Lancôme, which is their new Care and Glow formulation of their Tante Idol foundation, and Patrick Ta Beauty's newest and first face base product, which is their Major Skin Duo, a cream foundation and powder. Very, very exciting. Those are up next on the chopping block, but here we are today coming in close to test this all in one out. So though my hair is popping today, especially on this side, this is my favorite side always. It's funny how your favorite side changes as you grow up, because I used to love my left side. Now my right side's just coming in clutch. We're gonna clip them back so we have a nice clean area to work with. All I have on is brows and lashes. No concealer anywhere yet. I haven't concealed any of these veins. So unlike the foundation version of this palette where they actually label what shades are in what palette, I do not know what the foundation shades are within this. So we're gonna do a couple swatchy swatches together. It's gonna be so sad, but also so satisfying touching these pans. As you can see, you can also take each pan out individually if you wanna move it to a different palette or swap something out. I'm sure there's just magnetic separate sold on their website. I know 110 sounds like a lot for the foundation only, but for makeup artists, you guys understand, for this quality formulation, it's not that bad of an investment for 12 shades. Quite reasonable when one shade is usually sold for over $40, but this for $85? Steal! So our foundation shades are right here, here, and here. So I'm gonna... It's so creamy. As far as packaging goes, it feels very heavy because the magnet's inside the pans, and then it clips closed. We can just swatch on our face, actually. So this is first shade, second shade, and third shade. So I'm wiping it to the point that it's all clean at the end. That's why I use the same brush, but here we are. I think the third shade is closest to us right now. I am coming off summer shade, but I'm already seeing the decrease in the color of my tan line versus my regular skin. We'll be winter before we know it, it seems. So that's what we have there. And then let's do the concealer side. We have two correctors. So let's take the green, put it right here, switch it over for the salmon color. And then we have two concealers right here, which I'm going to use this brush for. Put it right there. That's really bright. Wipe it off a bit and then get the even lighter shade and put it right there. So Harmony 1 is for light to medium. Harmony 2 is for tan to deep. I don't know if I'm gonna fall within the cusp of it, but we're gonna figure out how to use this. Everything feels really creamy. It doesn't feel dry. And it does feel like a formulation that if you wanted to take your time and apply it and then rehydrate it with some sort of mist, you could totally do that and it would still blend well for you, because the creamy stick foundation never felt dry. I'm not actually sure what skin types this is recommended for. I wanna say it probably should be able to cover all because this cream formulation is quite forgiving. I just wanna swatch everything so you guys can really see what's going on. So we'll take the first blush shade that's in the middle, put that right there. It's actually less pigmented than I assumed as far as intensity. It is still creamy and such, but it looks really intimidating in the pan, but I kinda like how it applied. And then the more pinky shade of the two, right there. Definitely different intensities. And then last but not least, the contour. We're gonna just go to the middle shade first. Put that right there. Move the baby hairs and put the second shade right here, just so you can kind of see cohesiveness of the palette and what it offers. I know we're not gonna apply it like this, but. All right, so all of it actually feels very, very hydrating, so I think it's gonna be amazingly forgiving, but let's see, let's map a game plan together. So we have this as the foundation shade. I actually think this would be a better concealer shade, one of these two, than the actual concealers, because those are super, super ripe, but maybe we can use these as just accent colors. I will definitely be using a little of the peach under my eyes, because I have a little bit of discoloration there, and some green around my nose, because I have normal hormonal redness in this little fresh guy. And then contour wise, they're pretty similar. This is definitely the warmer shade of the two, so I'll probably stick with the middle contour shade and the lighter blush right now and see if I want to intensify things. So that's the game plan. Let's do it. Gently wipe this off with some micellar water and then rehydrate my skin. Try to avoid them eyebrows. There we go. Oh, excuse this redness right here. I'm getting like an eczema mark, broken blood vessels. I don't know. It's just been irritated there the last week or so. And you know, my eczema girlies understand. Sometimes a new spot will be like, surprise! And then you just have to deal with it. I mentioned in one of my recent videos that I'm going through a little bit of a face shape crisis because I actually was able to use like the faceshapeapp.com after watching a few TikToks to kind of analyze a few pictures of me. It's funny how they change my age depending on if I'm smiling or not. So good to know. If I don't smile, I look 4 years younger, supposedly. I guess it shows less, you know, lines or whatever. But when I smile, I do have more of a diamond face shape. When I don't smile, I have a little bit more of an oval face shape. But it actually analyzes as both because I guess I didn't understand as much as a diamond face shape is, but it just means your forehead's a little higher there, which it is a little higher than my sides. And then my chin and my cheekbones do this little thing. But then if I just rest, it's like, of course I look like an oval, but I definitely still have more prominent cheekbones without any filler. Like, the filler's all gone, y'all. That's years ago, y'all gotta let that go. I've always had really prominently high cheekbones, but always thought it was a little ovally. So now when I have to think about placement for cream products, I'm kind of confused. But you can actually be two face shapes. It's a thing. If you look up diamond face shape celebrities too, it actually makes a lot more sense. My sister's like, no, I think you're oval. And then she saw me next to some of the examples. She's like, oh, I get it. I think Shay Mitchell, Rihanna, like just cheekbone placement. I don't look nothing like them, obviously. They're. And there's just so many different versions of how to use this, like oval, diamond. It's usually a different forehead placement. All right, so I'm gonna follow this one. So this is oval, and this one, I believe, is diamond. So we have those two. They're very similar, except, you know, one's more round in the center, one's more wide. So we're gonna do that. We're gonna do a little blend of both. We're gonna do a dioval. Mm-hmm. Let's start with our foundation, which is gonna go in other places. I'm just gonna leave that kind of as a guideline of where we're not gonna touch. I feel like I should do this last though, but we'll just put a little bit on. I'm not really blending it in on purpose, but as you can see, it's a base. We'll put some of the middle contour shade kind of on my cheekbone. Sides of the forehead are different, so one wants me to do just the top, which I've never actually done, so I'm gonna do just the top. See how that looks. It does it like that. I think that's gonna be interesting. But I guess I'll bring it a little down the sides for the oval aspect. The chin is different. So for oval, you do right here, and for diamond, you do a little higher up like this. I think it's supposed to be like this. We can do both. Looks a little hot messy, but we'll figure it out. Blush is next, right above. And now for our concealer, I do wanna drop a little bit of the color corrector green, just kinda around here, and a little down here. Now taking a little bit of the peach, just under the eye. I have a bit of a dark hollow here too, so I'm gonna bring it up right there. Freestyling. And then I'm gonna take the lightest foundation shade as my concealer. It's kind of layering over that corrector a little bit. And then we're gonna take one of the concealer shades, which I think we'll use this one, the more peachy one, and kind of layer that onto the inner corner so it's really bright there. And then do that down the center of the nose, a little bit right here, and a little bit on the sides of the mouth, like the highlight points right there. All right, I look
insane.
Gotta get the nose contour right too, so mixing a little bit of both actually, and just kind of taking it down like that. It went a little crooked, as you can see, just a little bit, but paint the bottom of the nose. Ooh, this is intense. This is intense, buddy. But in this way of applying, we don't have a million layers on top of each other. I'm not saying that's an issue, but you know, that's not what we're doing today. And then our main foundation shade is in any other gap spaces, as you can see. A little bit here, a little here. All right, so I'm gonna take this kind of kitty paw brush to blend out our foundation and our concealer first, kind of blending it into the contour. I'm gonna save contour for last, except for the forehead, it seems, because the forehead is just retreating into the hairline. We're gonna mix it in. Where are you going? It went somewhere. We'll have to touch that up in a second, maybe. I don't know. It's gonna kind of pat, 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 pat my way around. Obviously, this is a very all-in review where we're just committing to the concept for fun, but you don't have to use every single shade on your face if you buy this. But sometimes I feel like it's important for me to say that just in case you think I'm implying that's the only way to use it. It's not. I'm sure the correctors are blended in. Ooh, my wrist is tired. Ah. I do have a Makeup Forever sponge that I think we'll go over with soon. This was released a while ago, but it's just your standard sponge with a little bit of a sharp angle right there. Taking this concealer brush from Anissa, and we're gonna get right into the crevice and kind of go across the lid a little bit too with whatever's left. I forgot about that area. And my poor eyebrow. Oh my God, my poor eyebrow got like the crap kicked out of it. Deserved better. It still feels so creamy. There's no tugging. There's no like, oh, we should rehydrate. Very, very creamy. But it doesn't feel horribly heavy either. It does just feel like that HD Stick foundation. Almost there, guys. We're almost there. So we're gonna kind of pat in this part. Pat the blush in. Gonna kind of go around. Ooh, y'all see that? I'm using the same brush with nothing extra on it from when we blended out our foundation. This is a trust the process moment. I'm telling you, I favor this side. I really do. I really do favor that side. Since the kitty paw pushes down, it's a little bit of a down on top of the cheekbone. And then I'm like pushing it up, if that makes sense too, on the bottom to try not to lose too much of everything. I need the smaller version of this, which would be my hourglass brush, to kind of do the same thing for the contour, kind of a kitty paw as well. Why did it look so scary in comparison? I think I need to re-highlight my nose bridge since it went a little far with the contour, but whatever gets it blended out. We didn't even need a sponge. Look at me. Look at me. I know half y'all were like, this is about to not be what you wanted, Sam. You're about to look a little messy that's hot. Emphasis on the messy, not the hot. But it's just beautifully, with just tapping motions. It's going in. Now I jacked something up because I tapped a little much on the top of my nose bridge. A little too much, so my most oily area of my face. It said don't tap that much with this brush. This brush is a little bit more impressionable. Like it leaves a little indentation. So we haven't touched the highlight in the palette yet. Everything else has been mauled. Not this guy, so I want to see what it feels like on my finger with my glazed donut-y nails. Okay, here we are. So I can definitely feel the product, the amount of product that's on my face when I touch it with my finger. It's something that I would recommend to be set if you are oily skinned. But wow, is that pretty? All right, I'm gonna take another kitty paw. This is Sephora's. Sephora's kitty paw 71. I don't know, I wasn't supposed to put it here, but here I am putting my highlight in places it shouldn't be. Going over it with the foundation. Get my lips back. We are very close to there. I want to highlight the cheekbone a little bit back here with our highlight shade. Yes, 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 yes. This is so beautiful. Added just a little bit more blush right here. One dot of the darker one. I see this little part, which is probably gonna bug some of y'all because I see it too. There's a little part right here, sending in one of my fine lines. Okay, so we're gonna fix this eyebrow real quick. A little bit more brow pencil because we've lost our shape. We've lost the inner corner because we were going so hard. Really not. I don't know how you feel about it, but I'm feeling pretty good about this. I feel like we could set it real quick, adding just a little more contour because I'm a shape addicted girl, it seems. I have a really easy time contouring this side of my face, but the side that actually needs it more, I suck at it. Absolutely suck at it, but just gonna pounce that in. My concealer brush fits beautifully in. I don't know, I think I look pretty darn fabulous. Yes, it's extremely dewy. It needs to be set. You can go one of two ways with this. You can take a mattifying setting spray, one size, which is possibly what I want to do because setting a powder would take a lot longer and I have somewhere to be. But also like, I wanna see what it looked like on set if you want, just. I did this side of my face. Just kinda let that like, just absorb in. You can see it's already way better. The glowiness is definitely in that contour area. The rest of it is reducing down. I like that. So this is a little much, but this is a little more maintainable. I see there's a little line of contour that we need a little attention to right there. And then I'm gonna take two shades of Jaclyn's loose powder, which we've used before and reviewed. And I'm gonna set it traditionally over here. Wow, still using the lighter shade. See, that would work for photo shoots. Like, that absorbed beautifully with no issues. Darker shade is medium, so it's sheer light and sheer medium.
Oh shoot, there's a lot of powder in here.
I have so much trouble getting the light shade out, but the medium shade just has no problem. Well, the light shade, all it does is have problems. As you can see, got a little stuck right there because I put a lot of the medium on. User error, totally fine. Getting too eager beaver. Taking some of the medium down to the side of the nose. Kind of pressing the powder in versus having it bake. I don't want it to get stuck too much. It is getting very tan on me now that I'm starting to lighten up. I never thought this was really medium. It's kind of like medium tan, but it's supposed to be sheer, quote unquote. This contour side still needs some assistance. We're gonna gently set that, bring it around the top, and then of course the chin. The light doesn't like to give me a lot of powder, but the medium really does. Take that, just kind of go around the face a little bit. You can still see the blush, which I think is very nice. Obviously my setting game ain't as good as my cream game, especially in a rush. A little lip oil. So this is the Kosas lip oil in Unhooked. You know, nothing on the eyes except for the lash right now, but if I had more patience in my setting game and really took the time, it would look probably 10 out of 10, but I'll take a 9 out of 10 right now. Even an 8. Look at the base. Look how smooth I look. Tell me I don't look smooth. So the contour placement is still up for debate, but it is a learning process. But if I'm gonna give a grade for the formulation of the All-in-One HD Skin Palette from Makeup Forever, I would give it, off first impression, an A-. I think if there's only two shade groups, there's a little wiggle room for people to fall through the cracks, if you know what I mean. And I think I'm getting close. If I was in my full summer shade, if I was like not at 85% summer shade, I think I would have a little bit of a struggle too, but the contour is gonna work. The blush is pretty. I think they're very similar. I wish I kind of did different blushes. And I am using one of the foundation shades mainly as my concealer, but the concealer is gonna be like popping on me if I used just those light shades. So I think that justifies an A-, but the formulation's beautiful for giving. The value is there. I don't know what else to say, because it's just, come on. If this is all you had, or this is all you could go get after you lost your makeup bag at the airport, you can't tell me you'd be that disappointed. If you have drier skin, I think you won't need to set it as much. I just used loose powder, and this is what we got. But if I was really just taking my time picking out my favorite pressed powder and stuff like that, 10 out of 10, 10 out of 10. So I was really excited to trust the process with this product. I hope you guys enjoyed watching it. I hope I didn't give too many of you stress and anxiety throughout the entire process. And I hope you enjoyed. So if you guys are interested in checking out the new All-in-One palette, I will link it off down below. Again, it is an online exclusive on makeupforever.com. If I am wrong in some sort of way and I do find it somewhere else, I'll link it off, of course. If you want some shade comparisons, I'll have them down below. The majority of them are on my blog, samrobson.blog/shades, but I do have a few in the info box that the character limit will allow. I will be back very soon with some wear tests, but I will leave my recent uploads on the screen for you guys to enjoy in the meantime, as well as the subscribe button if you haven't hit it yet and you would like to join our little fam. Stay tuned for my future content. She's right there. She's free 99. That is it for me today. I hope you guys enjoyed. Thank you for spending some time of your day with me. I'll see you guys in a later video.